Hey there, everybody. Welcome back to Jurassic's Edge. You already know it's Alessandro, your host. And today, guys, I am truly and truly excited to bring you guys one of my first Papal figures. As you guys know, before the video, previously, I reviewed the brown Papal Rex from the 2018 release. And today, I'm bringing you guys the 2018 version of the Acrocanthosaurus. And oh my God, guys, this thing is so beautiful. I am truly stunned by the way this animal looks. I have no words in the way of description of how beautiful he looks in person. Now, no review, no pictures, nothing's gonna capture the beauty of this animal the way that he looks to you in person. I do recommend you guys pick him up. Now, I picked this guy up out in Jurassic Quest, which is a dinosaur-themed fair that travels around the States here in the U.S. And, you know, one weekend it happened to be here in my hometown. And, you know, I made a video where I took you guys there and I showed you guys, you know, the fair so you guys can see for yourself. By the way, if you haven't checked it out, go check it out. And I picked this guy up and the Papal Rex. Now, I have never really picked up a Papal figure before. Now, this Papal figure, I just cannot resist, along with the brown Papal Rex. They're just too beautiful to turn down in person. I've always procrastinated it, and I just had to take the advantage and go out and get them. Now, we are gonna go right into this guy. I cannot wait to show you guys how lifelike and how beautiful, at least the camera can capture how he looks. I cannot wait to dig into him, and I'm gonna show you everything this figure has to offer and how beautiful he really looks. So guys, here we go. Now, starting off here with the head, as you guys can see, there's so many different colors within the head and the figure itself. You guys have kind of a bronze color kind of coming up from the neckline all the way through the back. Kind of makes its way to a stop, which I'll get to now. You guys have a pink and a blue, which kind of blend in here. I'm not sure what that's called, what part. I'm not gonna call it the nasal cavity, but you know what I'm talking about there. The eye is beautifully colored as well. He has like a kind of a looking up pupil, like he's looking up because he does stand in this pose, so he would be looking up at whatever he's trying to roar at. And as you guys can see here as well, look at all those scales, guys. Look at the scale work, all different kinds of sizes. Every single piece of a nano inch within this figure is detailed. There is not a spot that I can actually see that they did not put in as much detail throughout the figure. This is just absolutely spectacular and the best possible Carcharodontosaurus that we could have ever gotten in any form of a figure or model itself. Now here we have kind of the iconic kind of a squirt on the jaw, and the jaw is articulated as well. As you guys can see, there's spikes here and they're all different kinds of sizes, very pronounced. The teeth are all individually sculpted, looking phenomenal, guys. Just so lifelike in appearance. It's really crazy. The cartilage holding in the jaw right here, as you guys can see, it is a glossy color. Can't really see because of the lighting. But here you guys can see the tongue, it is colored in a pinkish color. And inside as well, has kind of a glossy finish to it, and I love it. But that's it for the head, guys. Now above, you guys can see right here that the scales continue on the top of the head, making its way down to the brow, looking very, very nice. The nasal portion is colored in. You see the nose holes there, they're colored in. And he is a gray with a black wash. The whole figure consists of that gray with a black wash. Now we're gonna make our way here to the torso of the figure. Now the bronze does continue towards along the back. He has the spikes coming back here too as well, because Carcharodontosaurus had somewhat of a sail. Not a full sail, but somewhat of a sail. Could have been used for communication, mating display, for heat, kind of like a thermostat, you know, in some kind of a way. We have here the black stripes everywhere here, which give it a very, very lifelike kind of a coloration to the figure. You know, it's not too much. It blends in perfectly with the grays and the bronze. Now here we have within this black kind of a circle, a kind of a blue color, which I kind of like that touch there. It's kind of like a dark grayish blue, and it looks absolutely spectacular. Now you guys can see, for every spike, you have the actual indentations of like a sail. You see, you got one spike here, and you have the indentation, spike, indentation, and it continues all along there. And it kind of comes its way to a stop here where there's no spikes, but then it continues along here on the top and then like towards the tail, right? And then it comes to a stop as well along here, as you guys could see. So the spikes are very, very, very detailed, and they look so beautiful, and they're in a pattern kind of position. Now here along the legs, he is in a crouched downward position, which I do like. I like this position mainly because it is a very, very displayable position to have him in. The legs are very, very muscular, as you guys can tell. You see the very, very muscular tones here. You know, the calf is very pronounced. You have like the scale, the scales and the folds within the skin as well, which you can see are very, very pronounced. And you can come down all the way to the leg. You have very, very bird-like and beautiful, beautiful feet there with that bird-like foot. You know, it's just so, so stunning to see in person. And back here, you guys can see the detail along the ankle as well is just truly stunning. Now, the bottom of the foot is sculpted too, and it looks absolutely spectacular, guys. Now, here to the arm, you guys can see very muscular arm. Everything is colored in, and the scales there are just like the foot, very bird-like in appearance. And the claws are perfectly sized to the hand, and the arms are perfectly sized to the body of the figure, which is something that, you know, you couldn't ask more of. And, you know, scaling works, you know, the scale works. Making our way to the bottom of the figure, you guys can see this very crocodile-like kind of armor plating here under the chest, which looks absolutely beautiful. You guys have folds here that like give the imitation of the heaviness of the figure. You know, the back, the saggy skin kind of drooping down absolutely looks spectacular. You know, you guys have very, 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 very minute details within the whole belly portion of the figure, making its way throughout the body and the private area as well. You know, you have all this detail. And here we have, of course, the tail. You see the spikes kind of dull out here. They just kind of disappear and they come back up here, and then they disappear again towards the tip of the tail. And you know, I don't mind it. It looks very realistic, and it's a very pattern-like appearance to the spikes. You guys have the stripings that continue, and they take over the entire portion of the tail, as you guys can see. Now the tail is in a slight curve, as you guys could tell right there, and it looks absolutely magnificent. Look how this tail scales perfectly with this Acrocanthosaurus. Looks absolutely spectacular, guys. Beautiful in appearance. And as you guys can see right here, he is posed in a crouching position, which, you know, Papo has a very, very unique way of posing their figures. You know, when they release them, they come with kind of weird poses, but, you know, I don't mind it. I really do actually like it. You know, they look actually very unique. We never got really an Acrocanthosaurus figure that I can really think of. I think maybe Schleich released one, but let alone in this position. You know, this position is very, very unique. And it looks like he's about to fight, or he's got some kind of action going on. And this figure really, really holds itself down, guys. Really holds itself down. This is an A-list figure right here. Papo does not ever let down. I mean, I don't know why I held so long. I mean, I know this figure came out last year, but I just don't know why I held down so long to pick him up. I really don't. When I saw him in person, I just could not resist. And I'm sorry, guys, but that's pretty much everything I have to say about this figure. This figure is just absolutely A-list. It's phenomenal. Looks so real. We've never gotten an Acrocanthosaurus with this major amount of detail and lifelike looking of an appearance to anything comparable to any Acrocanthosaurus figure we've ever seen before. I do recommend you guys pick him up. I do recommend that you guys start collecting Papo, because Papo, and they're not sponsoring me in any way, or I'm not sponsoring them. This is just my honest opinion. I never had a Papo figure in my possession until 2 weeks ago, and this is just my honest reaction. And I'm telling you guys that you guys have to pick up. If you're gonna pick up two figures, you're gonna have to pick up this guy, the Acrocanthosaurus, because you guys, I mean, this video is not capturing the immense beauty and lifelike appearance of this figure, guys. When you guys see him in person, I don't even have to tell you anything. You guys are just gonna grab your hands out, you're gonna hold him in your hands, you're gonna probably pass out, don't worry, you'll wake back up, and you're gonna take him, and you're gonna for sure buy him and bring him home and add him to your collection. And you guys are gonna get one hell of a shelf display with this guy. He is absolutely amazing. He has so much detail within him. He looks so lifelike. I know I keep repeating that, but it's just my, like, it's the words, and this is natural, guys. This is my initial reaction as well to the figure. I am so stunned, and I'm extremely grateful that Pappo, you know, we have a very affordable model making company. This Acrocanthosaurus costing me $25. He might be a little more expensive online. He might reach towards the $40 range. I know they released another repaint of this Acrocanthosaurus, but this one right here, guys, is the one that I know, and I know that this guy looks spectacular. I'm gonna give him a complete and utterly breathless taking 10 out of 10. Why do I give him a 10 out of 10? Just look at him. When you guys see him in person, you guys will understand. And you guys are seeing off this initial reaction. I mean, even on camera, you guys could tell that he's just jam-packed full of detail in every single inch of the figure. He does not miss out anywhere in the body. Everything is perfectly scaled up, and he looks what the Acrocanthosaurus should look like. Now, I think Pappo should release little minifigures, you know, like, that come with them, so you guys can get an accurate, for scale, an accuracy of what the humans would have looked like scaled up next to them. And I know, of course, Pappo doesn't make the dinosaurs scale up to all, you know, the figures that they made. They don't scale up to each other. And I'm gonna show you guys right now him right next to the Pappo Rex, which I did review. You guys can check it out down below, which I did review in my previous video. So I really do recommend highly that you check it out. And here they are next to each other, and they are beautiful, guys. Look, they look like they're about to square up in a match, and they're gonna take each other out. I really do love the way he's posed up, and I love the way that, you know, that they seamlessly blended in these beautiful colors together. And they never, ever, ever hold down. Whenever they release newer figures, they never hold down on the detail. They always bring their A game. So we have to give credit where credit is due. Pappo, you get a round of applause from me. Alright, you get a big old happy hug and a round of applause from me. And I'm pretty sure all the Jurassic community will love this as well. Now, he does look like a pretty good resemblance of what an Acrocanthosaurus might probably look like if it was featured in a Jurassic Park film, or Jurassic World for that matter. He has that kind of appearance to him, like a very lifelike Jurassic Park kind of a feel to the way he looks. And I absolutely love it, meaning that I can display him next to my Jurassic Park and Jurassic World figures, and it looks like he blends in perfectly to the franchise. If you guys enjoyed the content, please hit the like, subscribe, comment down below. Did you guys pick him up? Did you guys pass out when you saw him in the store? What is your favorite Pappo figure that you've gotten so far? Or have you guys decided on getting it and haven't gotten him yet? Let me know in the comments down below, guys. I love interacting with you guys, and I really do appreciate the support. You know, this is a brand new channel that I started, and I'm sharing and honoring my love for these figures and dinosaurs alike to all of you, for you guys to enjoy, and for us to have a little community together, and for us to, you know, all enjoy all of this content together. Oh, guys, I forgot to mention the dinosaur discovery. If you guys haven't heard about him, he is a very, very good friend of mine. You know, we chat down in the comment section below, and I checked out his channel, and he has everything that you would love to know about dinosaurs. He is currently releasing, well, by the time of this video, he probably would have released the Spinosaurus, the history on the Spinosaurus. He has pretty much all the knowledge you can ever want on all the different species of dinosaurs, guys. So I really, really highly recommend that you guys check out his channel. You guys will love it. And it's a very, very knowledge-based channel. He knows what he's talking about. He's gonna get all the information out, and you guys are gonna learn a lot. So I'm gonna leave his link down in the description down below, and you guys should check him out. I really do recommend. I enjoy every single one of his videos, and I'm pretty sure you guys will enjoy it as well. So I say again, guys, this is Jurassic's Edge. The park gates are about to close, and I do love the support. Stay dino strong. Till next time, Acrocantho loves you, I love you, peace.
Oh, hey there, everybody. Watch Jurassic Edge's latest video. So much content to learn. So much content to see. So entertaining. Till next time, subscribe and watch later for more.